Hey, my name is Pastor Casey. I want to thank you for tuning in to Solutions from the Scriptures. Today's subject is God is love. Hey, everybody believes that God is love, and that is a scriptural idea. Let me prove it to you. 1 John 4:8 says, "The one who does not love does not know God, for God is love." So there you have it. But let me bring some biblical balance to this wonderful idea. God is love. That is most certainly. But remember, He did flood the earth. Why did He flood the earth? Well, God is holy and He must punish sin. So the confusion comes in when we start to differentiate between love and holiness. So we must ask the question, what is God's primary attribute? God's primary attribute is not love, it is holiness. Remember, love is a fruit, it's a result. Galatians 5:22 says the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. So you see that love is a result, it's a verb, it's a byproduct of holiness. So love is not God's primary attribute, though it is a very important attribute of God. The number one attribute of God is holiness. Isaiah stressed this in chapter 6, verse 3. The Bible says, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." And then in Revelation chapter 4, verse 8, the same thing. "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." You'll never see in the Bible where it says God is love, love, love. You'll always see God is holy, holy, holy. And that's kind of like adding 10 pounds of emphasis on that first word. And it escalates to, again, maybe adding 50 pounds of emphasis to the next time you say that word. And then 1,000 pounds of emphasis on that word again. So holy, holy, holy means we really need to listen up, because God's holiness is primary, and that's first, and from that, the rest of His attributes flow. Hey, what about a church when they focus just on love? If a church focuses just on love and loves everybody out of that attribute and put that first, then holiness is lost. But when holiness is first, then everything else is in order. And the same thing is correct for your personal life as well. 1 Peter 1:16, God calls us here to be holy because I am holy. So then, when you speak and act and live from holiness, love will most certainly flow. 1 Corinthians 13:8 says that love never fails. How important is holiness for your personal life? Well, the Bible says in Hebrews 12:14 that without holiness, no one will see the Lord. That's pretty weighty. It's because of God's holiness that He must judge the world of its sin. And we've all sinned. So I pray and I hope that you have placed your faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, for being the substitute and taking the payment for your sins. So remember, God is holy, and from His holiness, all the rest of the attributes flow from that. Hey, if this has been a help to you, then forward it to a friend, and I hope to see you next time.